aplauso, Carlos.
Up there just like doing some little thing. I was like, alright, cool. And then we went to the bar and then we got up there, man, he just started wailing.
We just want to play music. Whatever we can do that. And so we gave up a lot of things in order to do that, and it's pretty incredible the three of us that all decided to make so many sacrifices together. Giving up jobs, giving up comfortable living situations, spending a long period of time on the road, putting all of our effort and energy into this.
It's in the water, it's in the air, till the moment you turn out the lights.
Showed up at their house and I walked inside and all their furniture was pushed over in the corner and covered up with like a tarp. And thought I'd made a mistake and walked into some tweaker's house or something. And walked downstairs and sure enough, they were all drunk. Figured out they're the perfect people for me to be playing music with.
I like the interaction with the crowd. My favorite part is getting lost in my music, and then when I open my eyes or I see somebody mouthing it or just staring at me, and kind of like I feel like I have this connection where it's like I know they kind of went where I just went.
I'm thrilled. What can I tell you? I was in the bathroom for like 15 minutes.
My family showed up. A couple of my family members have never seen me play before, so it's like a whole new set of nerves kind of come in to play.
A little nervous.
My dad actually gave us his blessing and respects us now. I think he'll actually love us.
I've always idolized stars, you know, when I've seen people dancing and doing their thing. Just in that element, I've always thought I would love to be on that level.
We've been recording, like really recording seriously, since about 2000.
Since we were little kids, I grew up like right down the street from him, so actually across the street, a couple houses down.
So sharp that it cuts our tongues. From the streets of the slums to the birds with the funds. Six shooter guns clap in the wild Midwest. Try to fly but you can't flee the cuckoo's nest. So you confessed that you just second best. Try to blow like me, cardiac arrest.
There's a fine line between loosening up and being too drunk to play.
Right.
We like
rock and roll lost its edge, you know? It's supposed to scare your parents and make you want to take your pants off. I want to bring that back.
I think I'm the only hip hopper I've seen locally that's in a wheelchair. So when you see somebody in a wheelchair, you're kind of like, what are they really gonna do?
We're gonna do our best, and I know they will too, but you know, we're looking forward to having a good time. Go as far as we can.
We're ready.
ready to get on stage. We're pumped. Just going to go up there and kill it, hopefully, you know what I mean?
We want everybody to hear it, you know, around the world. And we want to do this for our careers. And, you know, the music business is horrible right now, but, you know, that's not stopping us. We're going to keep going, and we're going to make this our jobs and our lives.
The audience loved it.
Gave it my all.